Next, fifth one. Period of phi sin x plus 3 cos x by 4 sin 2x plus 5 cos x. Okay. Let us say f of x is equal to phi sin x plus 3 cos x by 4 sin 2x plus 5 cos x. Here, just observe the numerator and denominator. How many trigonometric functions are there? If you just observe the numerator, there are two trigonometric functions. In denominator, how many trigonometric functions are there? Two. So that means total we have 4 trigonometric functions are involved in this function. So for each function we have to find out the period, then we have to find out their LCM to get the period of the required function. So let us do it. First, period of sin x, which is familiar, 2 pi. Period of cos x, which is also 2 pi. Period of sin 2x, very interesting here. You remember x coefficient is 2, that will be 2 pi by 2 pi. Again, period of cos x is same 2 pi. Now, LCM of 2 pi, 2 pi, pi and 2 pi we have to find out. So, LCM of period of our function f of x is equal to LCM of 2 pi comma 2 pi comma pi and 2 pi. See LCM 2 pi 2 pi pi 2 pi. Take pi 2 2 1 2. Take 2 divided by 2, 1 1 1. So now this is equal to, in this here LCM is equal to 2 pi. Therefore, period is equal to 2 pi. This will be the answer. Second section. First one, first bit. If 0 less than a, a less than pi by 4 and cos a is equal to 4 by 5, find the values of sin 2a and cos 2a. Okay. So, in this problem, our aim is to find out sin 2a and cos 2a. What is the formula for sin 2a? That is 2 sin a cos a. But we know the cos a. With the help of cos a, let us find out sin a. Cos 2a means in terms of cos we can express, that is 2 cos square a minus 1, so that we can find out. Okay? Am I correct? Okay. Here, given 0 less than a, a less than pi by 4, That implies A belongs to the first quadrant, no doubt. Cos A equals to 4 by 5. And we know that sin square A equals to 1 minus cos square A. This is 1 minus 16 by 25. Here 25 minus 16 is 9. So we get 9A is equal to square root of this one plus or minus 3 by 5. Since A belongs to first quadrant, sin A is also positive. So we can write sin A is equal to 3 by 5. Now let us find out these two values. So now sin 2A. Sin 2A is equal to 2 sin A cos A. So 2 multiplied by 3 by 5 into cos A is 4 by 5. This is 24 by 25. Let us come to the cos 2A value. What is the cos 2A value? Cos 2A is equal to 2 cos square A minus 1. You can have one more doubt also. Why can't we write 1 minus 2 sin square A? Why not? You can proceed for 1 minus 2 sin square A also. So now here 2 of cos square A is 4 by 5 whole square minus 1. So this equals to 2 into 16 by 25 minus 1. This is 32 by 25 minus 1. Now what shall we do? Take LCM 25. So 32 minus 25, that will be 7 by 25. Both the values have been determined in this case.